Okay, hello and welcome everybody. This is going to be a new campaign, grand campaign for Total War Rome 2. This is one of the factions I'm going to be playing as for the Black Sea Colonies DLC. Other faction I'm playing as at the moment is Massilia, but that is part of the DLC. We had a faction vote on my channel update, and you glorious people have chosen. Could have been Chimera or Colchis, and the grand winner will be Colchis. Chimera come up with 4 votes, and Colchis, if I'm pronouncing this right, probably not, is come up with 7. So this is the faction I actually wanted to play, and probably me saying that in the video might have egged people onto doing it, but either way, I'm happy, you're happy. They're very similar, due to the start. The initial challenge is hard. I'm going to play it on game difficulty hard, because the units they've got, so Scythian units and archers and stuff, very similar to one I played before, Royal Scythia. Again, initial challenge, hard. You start off with crap units, really, really bad units. So, miniature focus is what has got to be done first of all, research-wise. Trade, sod that, because we've already got a good trade from this. I'll go over the traits and stuff, and then I'll read the history tiles one for the actual Black Sea Colonies. You get the same thing for all 3 factions, and then the actual faction stuff there. So we have got Greek knowledge, plus 5% research rate. Far from home, plus 2 to cultural conversion, so these are going to be very good. We need it as well, because we've got weaker units. Trade crossroads, plus 15% trade income. So obviously we're trading with the famous Silk Road, which was connected to China and the Eastern influences. Negative, Golden Legacy, major diplomatic penalty with Greek factions, which is not going to help, especially with Chimera there. And Pontus and Pergamon, them kind of factions to the west of the Black Sea. And simulation, plus 4 happiness from presence of other cultures, which is going to be very good. I was going to read this. From around the 6th century BC, the Greek city-states began to colonise the far-flung corners of their world in order to grow rich from trading. The natural resources to be found there. Inevitably, this brought them into conflict with the local nomads, Scythians, Samaritans and the Roxiani. All resented the settlers. They civilised ways their wealth. Life in the Black Sea colonies, therefore, wasn't just a rush for wealth, it was a struggle for survival against a relentless, tireless opponent. And this is obviously about Colchis themselves. Far to the east of the Black Sea, at the very edge of the Greek world, lies Colchis, a place of legend. It is said to have been the final destination on Jason's quest for the Golden Fleece. Around the 6th century BC, Greek traders from Miletus arrived to construct a thriving mercantile colony from this former Persian satrapy. Its current ruler controls a powerful Greek trading state with strong Scythian influences and a nobility with the extol and final qualities of both cultures. His warriors fight in a Greek fashion, yet the ferocity of the nomadic past is very much alive. As such, Colchis has set out to conquer much of the land around it, to sort further Scythian tribes and as many former Persian lands as possible into his burgeoning empire. So victory conditions are standard for grand campaign. 80 settlements. We need to have the Corsicus, Bosporus, which is where Scythia is. Chimera is. Scythia, where the Royal Scythia is. Persis, which is Persia. Hellas, which is Greece. And we've got Egypt. So, and maintain 240 units, which is easy peasy lemon squeezy. Let's start it. Before we start this, if you're obviously new to the channel, please subscribe. I'll be doing this to the end for the campaign, and please give the video a like. It helps me out, especially for the first 2 or 3 episodes of the series, because obviously it gets me up on the search engine on YouTube, and obviously it brings new people to the channel. So anything to help me up, thumbs up. I'll give you a thumbs up for giving me a thumbs up at the end of the day, and giving them any comments as well of what you think, how we can progress with the campaign and kill the swine, kill them all, how we're going to conquer these lands. This will be coinciding with obviously my Massilia campaign. I'm going to be doing Spartacus Rises, the last 2 episodes I think this week, and should finish next week, by next week. That'll be all completed, And then I'm going to be doing a Valkyria Chronicles. I'm going to finish that off because I was on mission 5 and there's a total of 14 to do. Once that's done, I'm going to do another mod campaign and that will be it until February when Total War Attila arrives. I want to be pretty much clean with my series before that. These grand campaigns normally take about 2 to 3 months anyways, depending on how quick I upload stuff, so we should be alright until obviously February, and then have everything ready. Maybe play a few, if you're finished beforehand, before Attila arrives, then I'll play like another game and upload that nearer the time depending what's out, and then just upload that, so something on the channel at least, and then get ready for starting at least 3 to 4 campaigns when Attila arrives. That's the plan anyways. I don't want to start anything too close to the time. This land, the mythical country of the Golden Fleece, your people call home, is found at the very edge of the Greek-speaking world. Barbarian cultures surround you, but with the Colchis Mountains at your back, your primary enemy stands to the south. Traipsos are long-standing rivals and should be your first target for expansion. Further west lies the powerful kingdom of Pontus, which you must confront if you wish to dominate the sea. However, you may choose instead to send your forces inland where they will meet resistance from Armenia. War may come to Colchis, but you will be known to the length of the civilized world. So this is the start of the Colchis Grand Campaign. Hopefully we shall crush our enemies. Even though we do start very weak, and this is why it's a harder start. Our first objective is to completely control one province, and our reward is 2,500. If we control this province, we are dealing with this area. Obviously, we're not really going to care war these guys yet. We need to take out Traipsos. So I think first things first, we need to obviously get some food going. We're on zero. We need to go towards, because we've got absolute crap units. As you can see, we've got spearmen here. We've got rubbish spearmen, we've got horse skirmishers, and we've got slingers. These are the worst units in the game. Especially Eastern spearmen is so bad. But hey ho, we've got to work with what we got. Luckily we've got Hippias Lancers as our general units. We actually have to kind of use that to our full ability. Let's move this guy out and stick him in there. So we've gone down to public order as one. Let's see if it's going up. Culture's slightly going up, but we obviously need to go the military route first of all. We need to get a better camp and then we can get some better units. The spy will go inside here so they can rank up a little bit. We're going to get best units you can get at the moment is hoplites, so let's get 3 of them. Check diplomacy. Okay, Chimera hate us, but like I said in the beginning tab, obviously the Greek factions are very unfriendly towards us. They like trespassers against Pontus, so obviously if we attack Pontus, they're going to like that. Treaty with Syracuse, which are there, they don't like. Well, we can't help that, because that's obviously before we started. We've got the Cartli, which are quite neutral with us, so let's see if we can get some trade.
I will do you the honor of listening to
moderate, and they reject.
The gods rightly wish us to show humility and not enrich ourselves at your expense.
There you go, they accept. That's good.
Truly, my good and noble
Pontus don't like
your
us.
Kind words and learn.
So war with Traipsos, which I said is going to happen anyways. They're going to hate us. Trespasses against Armenia, which obviously they're quite friendly with, and then we're at war with these guys. I always say it wrong, but Traipsos. That's a spam term. But any tips for this campaign? This is not going to be as easy as the Massilia one, because you do get better units and you get better start as well. You've got a province capital, you've got a crappy settlement, you've got rubbish units. That's what I think the drawback for these guys are, majorly. And you have soddle money. Food will be done in 2 turns. Once this is research room, we can start building this, we can get some cav. It's already on like 796 as it is. So hopefully we can build up quickly with our units, so we can attack Traipsos. It'll try and poison them before we attack as well, so at least do some damage towards them. Okay, spy's gone up, which is good. So we can either go citizen cav and axe them, or we can go horse archers, eastern archers and peltasts. I think first of all we'll deal with this so we can get the melee infantry and we can get some cavalry, because at the moment all we can get are hillmen, which is absolutely diabolical, just like these units. We've got a couple of horse skirmishers which are not going to do anything, so we need to get some decent melee cav for these guys, citizen cav, and we'll get some axemen which will be my melee guys. So let's do that. One food, that'll be done in another turn anyways, and now we shall go... this one, so we get charge, melee defence and attack will be slightly improved, not anything special, but better than nothing. Better than a kick in the balls, so... At your command. And she's ranked up, so let's try and sort her out. And we get critical success. Still we've got solid money, so we can't even really build that many units. So still got to wait 3 turns, so just build up what we have got. So let's see what we're getting for trade. 51, 53, but we don't have anything to trade in, it's just the start of the campaign, so you generally don't get that amazing things. Armenia versus Pontus. And we've got fishing ports, so now we've got some food going. How much do these things cost? We get better garrison, which is good. It's only one food, 1862. Okay, we'll do that on the next turn. That'll try and sort out public order as well then. And we'll see you get better garrison. Sweet. And then we'll start getting some units once that's built. She's just ranked up again. And we start using her. I'll see what they've got actually in a minute. I'll send her down. Let's see what we're dealing with.
I'm not here to burden you with demands. My offer is what we
I'm gonna give you an extra 100. I need all the money I can get at the moment. Stupid biatches. So yeah, it's gonna take 3 turns, but hey ho. And we're going to go for manipulation and assassination as per usual. 1 turn for that, 3 turns for that one. So we can start building some troops with the money we have got. Probably like 1 a turn. What we got here? 14 units and they've got that one. Okay. And we need to check what garrison units they got. Pikemen, militia hoplites, mob and slingers. But obviously at this moment, joining with that is actually quite deadly. Normally it wouldn't be, but... and it's not even the province capital as well. Sorry, settlements within the province that we need to capture. We need to take out a Cartley and... it's the Ardhan? Okay, that's done. In case we want to get any province capitals, you best go this route. So we can get siege towers done. And then we'll start going the civic routes. So now we've got the barracks. Next one we're going to get is Noble Blood Cavalry and the Cartley Axemen. Okay, that's cool. And how do we get to that one? Okay, we need to go that route. So, upkeep cost for armies, that would get us some more money. We could do that now. Who are we going to take on afterwards then? Settlement. We might not be taking any province capitals yet. We do have 2 in the area though, Armenia and Cartley there. Could we get away with that? 2, 3, so 10 turns. Sort it, let's go this way. We're going to need to get these blood cavalry and other things. We can do the siege stuff afterwards, so we may have to kind of sod the civic route at the moment, because we need to be very focused on the army. So we've got 2 of these, and then we could probably get... how much these cost? 100? Good. Maybe 1 a turn for these guys, and they're 120 upkeep. Fucking hell, these ain't cheap. 130 for them. And these are 50. 50, 70, 80. Oh my lord. They're not cheap, are they, upkeep for these guys? Things are, we're going to need these units. We need them maximum. as melees, and then we can have the cavalry to deal with slingers and stuff. While our skirmish cav can cause some havoc with their guys. They're very weak though, so. And they currently just moved up. But if you could see the difference between the standard cav you get, standard melee, you've got Hillman here. Melee attack 27, weapon damage 26, 39, so damage the same, but melee attack is obviously better. Charge bonus 13, melee defense 37, 23, 50, so that's a lot of difference. Whoa, look at that. 15 armor, 75. And obviously base morale is a little bit different. Health is not too much different, but that shows you, doesn't it? Bloody hell. Yeah, it's going to have to be one at a time, I think, for these guys. It's going to take a little while. They just moved their army out anyways, so what we'll do is see where they are. Because we may be able to attack them. No further orders. What are we dealing with? Mercenary hoplites, militia hoplites, so we use our spearmen to go into these guys, and they've got cav as well. They've got two skirmisher cav and then three normal slingers. We're still building. Let's kick that off and see. No, we're not in range, so let's keep building. And so hopefully they might actually attack us. If they come into close range, then I'll quickly make a move on them. Oh, we may have a battle on our hands. Because if we can take that out, then we'll replenish and quickly move. Good omen. Let's check that out in a second. Construction. Civics. Okay, we are in range. They are 45 position. What can we get here? Eastern Javelinman. Eins. Yeah, we'll probably have to go Hillman, actually, I'd say. Because we haven't got any melees. Okay, so we have a full army stack now. Obviously, we'll get rid of these guys. I'll quickly... I haven't actually saved it yet, so... Wish me luck. I'll put these guys in the bubble as well, because I know it's only one unit, but Hippus Lance is actually a very good unit, so... fortunately, we can't poison unless we get rid of one of these. How much? We'll see how much this costs, actually. If poisoning is actually worthwhile. 367. I think I'll get rid of the javelinmen. We don't really need them as much, so let's get rid of them. Oh no! Okay, that doesn't actually matter, does it? No, you bastard! Oh, sod it. Okay, we can't use the spy anyway, so it doesn't really matter. Check this first. Ah, what a numpty. We could have done this before. So we get plus 3 tax rate, gravitas per turn, and plus minus 2 upkeep. Just do that, that will help us out financially a little bit better. We have a priestess from Dodona brings happy tidings. The rustling of the oak leaves has told her much of the future fortunes of our people. So we must celebrate. Indeed. And now we should attack. Let's see what the odds are like. Ah, that's in our favour. That's good. Very happy with that. So obviously now, once we take in this, we can quickly replenish for about a turn and then we'll quickly move against the garrison. We can take that settlement, we'll put some public order in there, we'll get some food and hopefully expand to some better units. Let's go to the battlefield. So what I suggest for this is, obviously we're dealing with the miniature hoplites, weak units, but I'll send my spearmen up against them. Well, these guys will flank. We can get skirmishers and these guys to deal some damage from a distance, because obviously they're going to be a 45 position. And we have one unit of Hippolytus Lancers. Ideally these are not going to be mercenary Axemen, we will get rid of them, so no problemo. Hoplites, doesn't think really matters how we group this up at the moment, because we'll move them in position a little bit later. Saying that they don't have any cabs, so we can actually probably put these together, it doesn't really matter.
General! Battle group awaiting orders!
And we do have the other general coming in, so. Hippy Lancers.
Orders, my lord!
Order, my general. There we go. Rock and Baller. They've obviously got citizen cap for their general and they've got horse skirmishers. Oh, they've actually got two horse Tarantin cap, forgot about that. Derpy derp derp derp. So we will actually stick. No, we're not going to disband that group. We're going to add that group together. And we'll actually stick both of these together as well. Let's start fast forward this, see if I actually come out and do anything. So the entrances are obviously north, east and south, there's nothing on the west. Get firing. They're not really going to be doing much damage, so let's get them over here. Our horses over here. Okay, first things first. Okay, start charging into these guys if we can. Okay, Okay.
Blinders and the devil!
Let's get him in there quickly.
Citizen cavalry!
Upriders at the double!
To Bowen! General! Full glory! A charge! A charge! Upriders!
Okay, let's not get him. Get him.
Orders understood. Awaiting orders!
Okay, let's actually get them. Guys, get that general out. We might be alright. Okay, let's get him round. And we'll get them in there, because they're not doing anything. Okay, let's start charging him. Kill their general, we might be alright. Team Alpha. Well, they got massacred, them guys. So the base morale is pretty shit for them. Let's get them in there. Let's get him on the side. Yeah, base morale absolutely pants for these guys. And we'll come back out. We're only dealing with hot potatoes now, so... getting to back of these, you might be alright, man.
We await your orders! Melee infantry ready! What are your orders? We await your orders! What are your orders?
Let's get a spearman over here, I think. And we'll get these back in now, because they're going to go into that side. We'll go into that group if we can. This group here. Guys. Okay, we're gonna charge into these guys. Once you break these guys, then we can actually get our spearmen in, so... damage. Okay, let's move it back and we get another charge in. Okay, let's get these guys back. Let's hit charging in, massacre these bastards. Might get this gemmer in as well. Let's see if we can go to these guys actually. Let's get this general to start going into them. We can just try and focus on getting the other units out about them. There we go, that's a nice charge. That socks, fuck them up. And then we'll charge back into these. Okay, now these hot potatoes can spin round. And they can go into them. We'll get these in here. Hope our general don't die. There we go, looks like we've got this now. Obviously we've taken our general's wound as well. We've taken a lot of losses though, it's the only annoying thing for this. And let's try and kill him off. Let's continue because we can get higher ranks. And they don't have any units to run off. Come on, charge.
To more glory!
Let's speed it up. Get out of there, guys. We don't want any of them to survive. We've obviously taken a lot of losses ourselves though. A lot of losses. Let's kill them and then wind it. Run, forest run. Yeah, so obviously these guys... Oh, it's these ones that got 25 base morale. That makes sense. This one's actually quite strong because you've got 51 base morale. Okie dokie. Hopefully if a couple of these have cost you victory, yeah, obviously. 1700 losses, we only had 1000 men left then, bloody hell. They got 135 for their hot potatoes. They got 70s. The main people that are probably getting kills on us was actually the towers. No, maybe not. That's his 1700. Yeah, it was actually, because look. Bloody hell. 678 kills they got. And look how many losses we got. 130 from them. Obviously, good. Best hot potatoes. They've done very good as well. Our cav did rubbish. Minus that unit. Spearmen actually done pretty well. But they'll bog down, first of all, getting some kills. And then these guys run off. They got a few kills, and these done mediocre at best, but Slingers, you don't expect them to do too much. But as you can tell, reason why I brought the other general in the mix is because them Hippus Lancers are very good for charges, and it's the only decent cab we've got at the moment, so... you need them to go into the sides or the rear of the enemies to make them their unit shake with fear. Now we've got to see what the aftermath is. You've lost a couple of units there already. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, about 5 units, I think. But that gem was dead, so we get a new one. Oh, 2 units, okay. And they've only got 1 unit left themselves, but obviously these are very, very weakened. Very weakened indeed. Six turns. Possibly get away for 2 turns, but they've got another army stack there though. We need to take advantage of this. Alright, let's leave him there. Oaken whispers, we've given thanks to the gods and all as well.
We need good fighters.
Let's get rid of this one. Very weakened anyways. Okay. Let's build a couple units per turn and then we'll get some axemen and then we'll move them back up again to attack. That would be the last unit we'll build, because then we can send Spike and move up now and see what they've got. We've got a general there as well. Okay, next turn they're moving up. Okay, let's poison these bastards. Okay, it's gonna help a little bit. Okay, so we'll get, then we'll stick a unit in there as well. We'll get a mercenary unit. Oh shit, son.
At your command. Make haste, men. At ease, men. Sign up, lads.
Okay, we've got that extra unit in there, and then we'll move these back. They're going to try and attack. Even if they do take it, we'll just take it back off them. And again, if they move back, I've got another replenishment turn, and I've got an extra unit while they're not building anything, so it's not all bad if they do take fastest.
There is much to be said for generosity between friends. It profits.
Okay, they are actually attacking, so any losses... Oh, sod that. We're not going to bother with the battle for that. We can all air resolve that. Okay, so they lost some units. Even better. And they're going to run off scared. So we're going to obviously go push straight onto Trapsos now. Sweet. We've got trouble populace. But we can quickly deal with that in a minute.
Finding shelter.
They're probably going to move back in time, but either way, they've got weakened units, which is good. We'll send this down, and then we'll quickly send the army back up. Let's poison this one. Okay, not good. We'll deal on the next turn. They may even be stupid enough to attack it again, so if they do... Oh my god, even better. So, cavalry unit recruitment cost, so we'll do that, and we'll see if we're going to attack now.
We take this settlement. We hunger for battle.
Whoa, man, we got some money. So we can go from two armies to four, one fleet to two, and we've got an edict we can do. We need to obviously sort this out. Okay, these go back. And we've got enough money for a general, so let's buy that. And we'll stick a unit in there as well. Of what's cheap.
Soldiering, it's a good life.
And them two, it'll make it go down a little bit at least. So, and we can defend against these guys. So they're going to be losing forces now. We've finally got this. Let's see if we can trade with anyone. Armenia. They still don't like us, but...
Welcome, honored emis...
Francis don't like us. Okay, I see what the next turn is, and then we'll end the part there, because it's quite a long one at the moment. These guys need to replenish as well. But what have we got here? Anyone rank up? General did, no one else did. We'll get rid of their mercenary units at some point as well. Because then we can get some more money to convert things over. We're going to get a bit more money from Trapsos. But we need to finish them off, and then we can try and sort out this army stack. We can get some better units with it. Seven. We'll probably get rid of these now, actually. That's actually minus 10 as well. We need to obviously get some cultural conversion going on. So what we'll actually do is save the money for that.
We hunger for battle.
It will gradually go up according to this. If I kick on the settlement, that would help, wouldn't it? Eastern is going up. It's not good then, is it? Do we need to go eastern? It's actually eastern then. We should be nomadic. Hellenistic we need to be, so... Prussian. Okay, we'll try and sort that out in a minute. Let's see what happens within the next term. If not, we'll use our money. We need to get about 1500 roughly to do that. But at the moment, we should be safe from at least traipsers from attacking us. And we need to try and get some other settlements. We've only got one of each at the moment. And we haven't got province capital. So we need to build up and so we can attack that. Okay, they've just landed as well. Penalization. Inflation falls. Population surplus. Okay, now we can do that there. Obviously I just spent my money on that. That has gone down to minus 2 now, which is good. So it will eventually go down. And then we'll save up for that. So unfortunately we've got to wait until things are done, but... They're weakened and we still got garrison, very strong garrison actually, so it shouldn't be a problem. We need to try and sort out public order at the moment. Let's stick her in there. We may have to send someone over. I think we need to go civil route now. We need to get some more money and we need to obviously try and sort out public order. We've got the Mitchell means to a certain degree now. We need to shuffle them around and then we need to go civic route. So we'll do civic route. Once we've done a couple civics, we'll do obviously siege towers so we can start attacking these province capitals and do some real damage. But that'll be part one. Bit of a mayhem with this one. But it's a very hard start and it's a bit of a slow start, so bear with me. But by part three or four, we'll probably have about another two, three settlements, I'd say. Main thing for these guys is to get your money correct and units, because you can't be running around with shit mediocre units. We need to get some decent ones, which will be the Blood Cavalry and the Cartley Axemen as well, which will be very good, so we can start dealing some damage to some people. But I hope you enjoyed the first part. If you're new to the channel, please subscribe. Leave any comments you like about the campaign or dislike about the campaign, and again with a thumbs up or thumbs down for the video. Hope you enjoyed it, and I'll see you all in the next part.